Michelle. I was from Reston, Mayberry, USA, from Heavy Metal Parking Lot. I'm here to watch my husband's band. Their name is Volmer, and they're performing tonight with Vince Neil.
Where'd you come from tonight?
Reston,
Virginia.
Mayberry, USA. 1986, I was 17 years old, and I would go to all the local bars and clubs and Capitol Center and watch anything that was heavy metal.
Tell me, what has life been like since the heavy metal parking lot?
Talking. Big change since it's been so long. Of course, life changes as time goes by, so children and dogs and a house and that sort of stuff, but the heavy metal hasn't changed. We still really enjoy it. I've heard before that people say that you grow out of it, and I think if it's something that you love, you don't grow out of it.
My mom bought me tickets to this concert, please. What do you mean?
Have you seen any of these folks since the parking lot?
No, I have not.
Where do you think they are? You know where Jay is.
I know where Jay is in California. I have no clue about the rest. Well, I think Sean is still probably in Reston or Sterling, somewhere around the area. But the other two, I have no clue about. And I really don't remember too much about this day, but I do remember Brian had a few drinks.
How did you all meet and get together?
We met at a Gary Moore concert at the Bayou in Georgetown.
Internet.
And we met one night and our eyes locked and the rest is history. That was 1987.
The music had something to do with it.
Well, yes, he was a guitar player and I dated only guitar players back then with long hair, so he qualified.
What do you all think about Dokken?
Dokken, we've opened for them before, and it was really cool. They're great musicians, and we had a good time. It was a great crowd, so.
Yeah, we still really enjoy them. We still listen to Dokken. Yeah. I really like Lynch Mob a lot, too.
I had a friend of mine who collects guitars from back in the 80s, and he does a lot of internet surfing, and he came across your website and found the video, and he ordered it. And then he called me on the phone and said, hey, your wife's in this video. And we didn't believe him. And then he played it on the phone for us, and it's Michelle's voice.
I knew exactly. And when I said Reston was like Mayberry, I knew that was me.
So he loaned the video to us, and we couldn't believe it. So it was really cool to see Michelle out there in the parking lot of the Cap Center.
I saw what we looked like back then, and, you know, it's a big crack up because everyone is so different. And I guess the biggest thing about the movie is you just wonder what's happened to everyone. It's been a long time.
Well, that's why we're here today, Michelle. And actually, keep the camera rolling. Here, stand back, get more of a wide shot, because I'm going to get into this. Michelle, I want to thank you. You're actually the first person from the parking lot we put on videotape. So, that's a really, we're really honored that we got to meet your acquaintance and everything. And to see here, you're here, still thriving, rocking away in Virginia here. And just to honor the occasion, I want to give you, here, you hold the microphone there for a second. Actually, I want to give you your own official heavy metal parking lot t-shirt.
Thank you.
One of us has got to get killed.
Yeah. He might.
Wait a minute. We got to come over here. All right.
Wow! I'm David Helvey. I'm 37 years old, and I'm ready to rock. Been 17 years since Heavy Metal Parking Lot. I hadn't seen it till about 6 months ago, and ever since I've been checking up on it. I got in touch with you guys, and it's been really exciting. I just couldn't believe that this actually happened. So you all came over today. You're gonna hear us jam. We're gonna rock, and I'm still into it. I hear a lot of the stuff where people are actually talking about people may be embarrassed about back then. Not me. I love it. I'll tell you some more about this when we can get in and out of the rain. This is my brother's studio at North Beach, Maryland.
Is that what you
wanted
to say?
Yeah, that's okay.
All
right, so I'm gonna go order a pizza now.
Right. Want me to order a pizza now? Time. Want to do it again?
My buddy, Wolfgang, he called my brother and was talking to my brother and said that I was on like this large cult following underground rock and roll documentary, and I heard about it and I didn't understand.
Some guys gave me Heavy Metal Parking Lot, a dub of it, and I was sitting down watching it with some friends and we were like,
you know, I'll bet we know some people in here, you know? I was like, I'll bet those are some people that went to my high school. And then suddenly, my name's David Helvey. And I was like, holy shit, that's David Helvey.
I'm David Helvey, I'm 20 years old. I'm ready to rock.
I asked him about it. He said, yeah, yeah, come check it out. And he played it. And I just sat back and I was tickled with it. I thought it was funny. Because, and it still was interesting because I still felt like I was, you know, at that age. Or I don't feel like I changed that much.
Hey, so I'll be in the Air Force in about 2.5 weeks.
What do you know about Dawn from that day? I'm from when she was 13. Like, did you hang out with her? I mean, kind of a big age difference.
She was in middle school, but my mother and father went to school with her mother and father. So I would see her, you know, often, and she liked rock and roll, and I played in bands, and I liked rock and roll. So she was real happy to call me up and say, I got Priest tickets, and I was like, yes, and I said, I'm going. So I went, and we had a good time.
Dawn, 13.
Were you boyfriend or girlfriend?
No, she's my friend, and she always has been.
It's good you can set the record straight that you guys were just friends.
Yeah,
and
we still are. And we were talking and on email a couple times. And
how's she doing?
She's doing great. She's married, has a couple two boys, I believe. Started a carpet cleaning business in 87, was doing that. Up to 97, I went to school for 4 years. Then I became a DC third class engineer, steam engineer. And that's what pretty much my profession is right now. You know, I still clean carpets because I enjoy it. Sounds strange, but I can get my cardiovascular the same time I'm getting paid for it.
We also have somebody here who I want to acknowledge and thank for coming out, because it's a really, really rare treat to actually have somebody who is in Heavy Metal Parking Lot. And his name's David Shipman, and he's in the back right there. I don't, Dave, can you stand up, maybe? Anything you'd like to say about your appearance?
Nothing's changed.
everybody here a nice round of applause for David Chipman, who is in the film. What scene were you in?
After the Timmy, the friend that had died, or the friends that, little Pan, me and four of my friends were there against the Maverick with the primer all over it.
Was that your car?
That was my friend Dan Gore's car.
Really? He was in the scene, the camera panned to the left.
It wasn't even a scene.
In fact, it was frames. But if you stop it, you can see David from about 16 years ago.
Now, when did you first see the parking lot?
Oddly enough, not until about 2 years ago. So it had happened and it had gone on cable access. Nobody knew about it. I didn't know about it. My friends didn't know about it. And then it just a few years ago, it just kind of got, there's a buzz about it. And I said, I'll see that show. Let me take a look at that. My friend and I, Dan, who owns the Maverick, in a little scene, we were sitting back just watching the movie and he was just like, oh, hold on a minute. Stopped it, went back. That's us. It's kind of funny. It's kind of funny.
What have you been doing since then?
I make eye glasses. I'm an optician. I work with a group of optometrists in Greenbelt here.
Did you remember the cameras at all? Do you remember anybody walking around with cameras?
Well, my friend Dan, who isn't with me tonight, who is quite a character himself, was heckling you guys, trying to get your attention.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so there was the serious moment with Timmy and Timmy's friends, and then we're kind of over there griping a little bit, and then finally, you know, you paid us off with a little pain.
Oh, no kidding. Yeah. So that's why I did it, or whoever.
There was a little bit of heckling, and then finally you panned over, and we, hey, it's us over here.
That's funny. You probably didn't even know they were talking about some guy who died.
No, you know, I think we did.
Oh,
I think
really?
We did, because they were very proud of their backstage passes. I was there to see Judas Priest and had been very excited about seeing Judas Priest for, you know, the third, fourth, fifth time since 81 or 82. So it was, I wasn't there to get all screwed up and hammered and be a moron. I was there to see Judas Priest.
So tell us about your other friends who were in it. What are they doing now?
Oh, man. A couple of them are going to school. One of them works for American Express. He's a stockbroker. The other one I don't really know too much about, Jeff, that is. But I'm close with Danny and Kelly, the other two guys that are leaning up against Danny's Maverick there. I'll tell them how funny it is just in a geographical sense of how all the Maryland people.
Right.
You know, just how Maryland the documentary really is.
Yeah, that's true. You're right.
Me and my friends, we always joke about that in particular. It's really funny.
It's a very,
it's
very,
like, this is what we're from, fellas.
Hey, I'm sorry to, you know, put you on the spot.
Hey, that's all right.
This was great.
All right, you know?
Hey,
thank
hey,
you.
Hey, really good to have a...
Thank you.
Timmy loved the priest, at least all his friends say. As he took his Camaro up in the hills, much too fast, and down logging roads on his way into oblivion. And everyone met backstage in Largo, Maryland. And I guess there's some things I'll never understand. As I listen to the words of the zebra man, he don't know, he don't understand, zebra man. He don't care, he don't fear, zebra man. He don't care, he don't fear, zebra man. Oh, he don't know, he don't understand.
It's like when Stanley met Livingston.
Here he comes. Here comes somebody.
Hey, Dylan. Hi, how are you? I'm John Hine. Sorry to bother you this afternoon. I don't know if you got a letter from us earlier this year. I'm a, this is Jeff.
Hi.
We're filmmakers.
How are you?
Washington, D.C.
Did you get? Nice to.
How you doing?
Good.
And we made a documentary video at the Capitol Center back in the mid 80s. You hear about it?
Yeah, I did.
You did hear about it. Okay. That was you. Yeah, that was
that
you.
Was me.
We've actually met with people who were in it. And some people have like stumbled upon it or friends have told them they're in it. But you're probably the most popular person.
You really make the biggest impression.
You make the biggest impression.
Yeah. Wow.
Do you know people, they actually call you Zebra Man. So you really haven't, nobody ever said to
no,
you?
No, no, absolutely yeah. No. No, I stopped hanging out with those guys a long time ago. Yeah, I kind of faded away, got into hunting and fishing, just got out of the nightlife stuff.
Yeah, well, we weren't into metal particularly either, but we had, you know, That was
kind of been a touchstone for us. You know, we really didn't anticipate the success of this thing, and it's just gotten to be pretty popular worldwide.
Really?
Yeah. And you're a very favorite part of it.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, you know.
Yeah. Jeez,
I mean,
that's awesome.
We would love to bring you up to speed on this thing. You know, I think
Ian
what
people
will be real happy to see that you...
still alive.
Yeah. Exactly. Are you still into metal?
No, actually, I went to country pretty much.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Believe it or not.
Because yeah, we talked to a couple folks. And
I still like it. I just, yeah. You know, it's hard to get a good station that just plays that. Oh, yeah. And throwing a bunch of rap and other stuff on.
Yeah.
I'd like to get a copy of it, though.
We can hook you up. We got some in the car. We'd love to show it to you. Yeah.
Yeah.
We're going to show you for the first time ever. You've never seen Heavy Metal Parking Lot.
Hmm.
So this is...
So, from 1986. What? Remember where you were? May 31st, I think, 1986. This tape's not playing. It's all tape is all. The image is all broken up. It's not playing back right on this camcorder here. But this is gonna. All right, here we go. There's sound here, but it's not playing back.
Mm-hmm.
Can't hear a thing. The tape does not play back right on this camcorder. Is there any way to get this to work any better?
Oh, God, I don't think so. Unfortunately.
Zebra Man. Oh man. That was me.
Yeah, so you were big into metal back then?
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, you were in a band?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is great, David. I want to make an official presentation to you of Heavy Metal Parking Lot. We're very happy that you've been a part of it. And here's a second copy for you. I'll give you two. In fact, you can have as many as you want.
Two is fine, thanks.
And John, do you have something else for him?
I got a T-shirt. We do have souvenirs.
Awesome.
Here you go. We got your large, your extra large, but you like it. All right, good.
He don't understand, Zebra Man. He don't care, he don't fear, Zebra Man.
What's your philosophy on
life? No, it's me.
Oh.
Yeah. It's such shit. Heavy metal rules. Heavy metal rules. All that punk shit sucks.
And from here we're gone to Ocean City to party more.
From Ruston, Mayberry, USA, from Heavy Metal Parking Lot. I'm here to watch my husband's band. Their name is Volmer, and they're performing tonight with Vince Neil.
Where'd you come from tonight?
Ruston,
Virginia.
Mayberry, USA. 1986, I was 17 years old, and I would go to all the local bars and clubs and Capital Center and watch anything that was heavy metal.
Tell me, what has life been like since the Heavy Metal Parking Lot?
Talking. Big change since it's been so long. Of course, life changes as time goes by. So children and dogs and a house and that sort of stuff. But the heavy metal hasn't changed. We still really enjoy it. I've heard before that people say that you grow out of it, and I think if it's something that you love, you don't grow out of it.
My mom bought me tickets to this concert, please. What do you mean?
Have you seen any of these folks since the parking lot?
No, where, I have
where do you
not.
Think they are? You know where Jay is.
I know where Jay is in California. I have no clue about the rest. Well, I think Sean is still in, probably in Reston or Sterling, somewhere around the area. But the other two, I have no clue about. And I really don't remember too much about this day, but I do remember Brian had a few drinks.
How did you all meet and get together?
We met at a Gary Moore concert at the Bayou in Georgetown.
Internet.
And we met one night and our eyes locked and the rest is history. That was 1987.
The music had something to do with it.
Well, yes, he was a guitar player, and I dated only guitar players back then with long hair, so he qualified.
What do you all think about Dokken?
Dokken, you know, we've opened for them before, and it was really cool. They're great musicians, and we had a good time. It was a great crowd, so.
Yeah, we still really enjoyed them. We still listen to Dokken. Yeah. I really like Lynch Mob a lot, too.
I had a friend of mine who collects guitars from back in the 80s, and he does a lot of internet surfing, and he came across your website and found the video, and he ordered it. And then he called me on the phone and said, hey, your wife's in this video, and we didn't believe him. And then he played it on the phone for us, and it's Michelle's voice.
I knew exactly, and when I said Reston was like Mayberry, I knew that was me.
So he loaned the video to us. And we couldn't believe it, so it was really cool to see Michelle out there in the parking lot of the Cap Center.
I saw what we looked like back then, and, you know, it's a big crack up because everyone is so different. And I guess the biggest thing about the movie is you just wonder what's happened to everyone. It's been a long time.
Well, that's why we're here today, Michelle. And actually, keep the camera rolling. Here, stand back, get more of a wide shot because I'm going to get into this. Michelle, I want to thank you. You're actually the first person we've... from the parking lot we put on videotape. So that's a really, we're really honored that we got to meet your acquaintance and everything, and to see here you're here, still thriving, rocking away in Virginia here. And just to honor the occasion, I want to give you, here, you hold the microphone there for a second. Actually, I want to give you your own official Heavy Metal Parking Lot t-shirt.
Thank you.
One of us is gonna get killed. Yeah. He might.
Wait, we gotta come over here. All right.
Ow! I'm David Helvey. I'm 37 years old, and I'm ready to rock.
It's been 17 years since Heavy Metal Parking Lot. I hadn't seen it till about 6 months ago, and ever since I've been checking up on it. I got in touch with you guys, and it's been really exciting. I just couldn't believe that this actually happened. So you all came over today, you're going to hear us jam, we're going to rock, and I'm still into it. I hear a lot of the stuff where people are actually talking about, people may be embarrassed about back then, not me. I love it. I'll tell you some more about this when we can get in and out of the rain. This is my brother's studio at North Beach, Maryland.
Is that what you want to say?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I'm going to go order a pizza now.
Right. Want me to order a pizza now?
Want to do it again?
My buddy, Wolfgang, he called my brother and was talking to my brother and said that I was on like this large cult following underground rock and roll documentary, and I heard about it and I didn't understand.
Some guys gave me Heavy Metal Parking Lot, a dub of it, and I was sitting down watching it with some friends, and we were like, yeah, I'll bet we know some people in here, you know. I was like, I'll bet those are some people that went to my high school. And then suddenly, my name's David Helvey, and I was like, holy shit, that's David Helvey.